And it's always great to see fighters added to the women's flyweight division. We can get up and get excited for this one as we have Victoria Leonardo and Manon Fiorot making their respective UFC debuts. And Matt, for Shreveport, Louisiana's Victoria Leonardo, she's a commodity that a lot of people in North America have come to really recognize over the last couple of years. She's continued to put on really good performances over with Invicta. She was in the Phoenix series the second time around. Unfortunate that she ended up losing a second time around to Miranda Maverick there. But hey, it doesn't matter. You look at her last three fights. A little tricky where she got finished by Erin Blanchfield to start 2020. She picked up a big win in her second time out against Liz Tracy. And then after that, a win over on Contender Series against Chelsea Hackett, who was a really hyped prospect coming out of from Oceania with a great Muay Thai background, her father in her corner. You look at that fight and kind of some parallels between that fight and this fight, the fact that Leonardo was matched up with a younger striker, and I get it. These fighters are only a day apart. So it's one day's difference over on Tapology, but it's still younger fighters. So you look at the fight against Hackett, Leonardo was a decent size underdog in that one, more than a 2-1. And she did get rocked at one point, but she was able to finish the fight on the mat from full mount, hammering away. If you look at Manon Fiorot, this is a fighter that I haven't been hyped about a French fighter like this since what?
Tom Duquesnoy,
Cyril Gane, maybe. Kid. I don't know. Alain Badeau. But Manon Fiorot has really been making moves, whether it was with the IMMAF championships back in 2017. She won them at Bantamweight. You look at her pro debut. She took on Leah McCourt in Cage Warriors and lost a split decision. First round definitely went her way. The last two rounds probably went Leo McCourt's way. And she's really been a superstar over with Bellator on commentary and even in her fights. So for Manon Fiorot, she goes from that to EFC. And they call it The Fighter. It's like The Ultimate Fighter, but The Fighter Season 2. She goes there, wins that, beats the champion, and then she's queen of EFC. So then what does she do? She goes and fights with UAE Warriors. And I watched every fight, because you gotta. But she had three fights in 2020, finished all three. And if you look at the level of competition, it's so-so. The first fight against Quebec's Corinne Laframboise was probably the toughest test because if you look at it, she totally outstrikes Laframboise. I don't know if I've ever seen a nose injury that bad. She looked like Arlovsky at the end of the second into the third. But she continues to pressure. She continues to try and land power shots. She was a champion jiu-jitsu fighter. And again, record's a little salty, but she is a good fighter. If you go back and watch that one, it was halfway competitive. The commentary with UAE Warriors, if you watch all three of those fights, incredibly one-sided for Manon Fiorot, so maybe just hit mute on that one. But she picks up a huge win there, ends it at the end of the third round. TKO win there. She beats Naomi Tataroglu, and that one wasn't really close at all. Tataroglu just kind of chased her around. And then if you look at her last win to win the belt, the flyweight belt that they created, she beat 6-1 Gabriela Campo. Again, Campo wasn't really on that level. It wasn't really a close fight whatsoever. Kind of looked like, you know, the writing was on the wall probably 30 seconds before she finished it. But the big takeaway from Manon Fiorot is the fact that she has a kickboxing background, and you can see it in every single one of her fights. Her karate and her kickboxing are her championship-type level thing that she possesses. The two things with that, throws a crazy kick to the body. She really tries to establish distance with that push kick to the body. She'll kick to the legs, kick to the body. She's good on her back foot. And she is, and I'm going to cue up the clip, she is the Maria Sharapova of MMA. So overall, Matt, in this fight, you got Sharapova taking on Leonardo. And if you look at Victoria Leonardo, very good base in MMA. She's a black belt in Kung Fu. She's got a bit of a jiu-jitsu background. Her striking's very good. Her and her husband, Brent, and it's mostly Brent, but Brent owns Elite Combat Academy. In Shreveport, trains sometimes with Andrea Lee. You see her training over in Texas with some different gyms. But overall, Victoria Leonardo, very competent fighter. And I just have to mention this before I throw it over to you. And I know I've talked quite a bit. But with Victoria Leonardo, you go back to the loss against Erin Blanchfield. She had her hands nice and low. Blanchfield landed one head kick in the first round that stunned her. And she cracked her head off the back of the mat. And then in the second round, didn't make any adjustments. One kick, two kick, fight's over. Then in her second fight against Liz Tracy, she starts to bring her hands up quite a bit more. She keeps a fist, but it's up kind of close to her head. And I remember thinking in the first round, oh, she's made the adjustment. Then in the second round, Laura Sanko goes, she's made the adjustment. In her fight against Chelsea Hackett, where, again, there's a lot of parallels between the fight with Fiorot here and the fight against Chelsea Hackett, being classically trained strikers, and especially, you know, Muay Thai striker. Not to say it's totally similar to karate and kickboxing, but there are a lot of parallels that you can draw between the two of them. You can. Both strikers. Not really both strikers.
Karate, though.
But if you look at Leonardo, the start of that fight, her hand is glued to the side of her head. She is not getting head kicked, not losing that opportunity. Of course, again, she did get rocked early, but she ended up finishing the fight. I'm really excited about this one. I think there's a lot of potential with both of these fighters, maybe one more so than the other. But overall, I'm looking forward to it. What were some of your takeaways from this one here?
Okay, so for Victoria Leonardo, her issue is she doesn't do anything all that well. And we see this a lot, especially in sort of the lower level of women's MMA. Finishing ability really matters, and really overall aggressiveness matters. Fiorot has those in bunches, and that's what you're going to see. She's one of the few women's flyweights who will consistently get finishes because she's not afraid to really sit down on her shots and go for damage over volume sometimes. With Leonardo, she won't always just commit to either one of the games. She'll go for more of a volume-heavy game plan. Now, she can incorporate the wrestling in a little bit more. Fiorot, though, for the most part, should be able to just beat her up on the outside. I really like the kicking game of her, the overall kicking game. And really, she fights like if you just heard Joe Rogan do commentary on, like, an Antonina Shevchenko fight. If you heard about, oh, how great her kicks look and whatnot, it more describes what you're going to get from Fiorot than you would from an Antonina Shevchenko. Really nice Muay Thai, really good karate as well. Just sort of a uniqueness to the way in which she moves compared to a lot of other women at this division. And for really not just that reason, I like Fiorot a lot in this fight for how close the odds are.
I agree with you as well. I mean, for Victoria Leonardo, I think that she does have a lot of power. She moves forward quite well. She can chase some of her
opponents.
She's
short arms, though. That's the issue. She doesn't commit to her punches as much as she just throws them.
And the thing with Manon Fiorot, again, she moves so well on the outside, especially being a southpaw. It really throws a wrench into a lot of her opponent's plans. I know in the fight against Corinne Laframboise, that was kind of the issue, too. She was always moving, always doing something. And again, she establishes distance so well early on with that kick to the body. Then she'll go to the leg. She'll go back to the body, where it just frustrates opponents to start making mistakes. The other thing with both of these fighters, I think if Victoria Leonardo is going to get a win in this fight, she probably has to try and take the fight to the mat. And I know if you look at Manon Fiorot, you probably think, well, she has such an extensive striking background. Her ground game is probably not all that great. She was willing to take the fight to the mat against Corinne Laframboise that had the background in jiu-jitsu. She's willing to do it in the other two fights as well. And again, Leonardo would probably have success with the wrestling. We've seen her have success with it in the past. Manon Fiorot, though, when she does get onto the ground, again, we've seen her in mount position a lot. But if she's in half guard, if she's in full guard, she's at least doing something to try and advance. She's always trying to rain down strikes, do something. So that's why this should be a very interesting fight. Again, you mentioned the odds, so let's bring them up. You have Leonardo opening a minus 110. They both open at par. She's now a plus 137 underdog. For Fiorot, she opened minus 110, now at a plus 165. Over on Tapology, limited sample size of the votes, 458, 61% going Manon Fiorot. You have 46% by decision, 47% by knockout. I'm really high on Manon Fiorot in this one. I'm taking the French fighter here. I think this is a huge opportunity again. She had the three fights with UAE Warriors, so you've already got the UFC brass moving in and out of Fight Island. You probably impressed them enough. I know the commentary team, again, I can't say enough. They were so biased. But overall, I really do like the game of Manon Fiorot here. If Leonardo gets a win, probably taking Fiorot down as early as she can, or maybe countering on a power shot. But overall, again, I like the beast Fiorot here.
So for Leonardo, she really has to limit the movement of Fiorot. And if she can get her up against the cage, not to use that as a damaging position, but really just use that to wear on the footwork and the movement of Fiorot as the fight continues. I'm going to side with Fiorot. I agree with you, Craig. I think she's the higher ceiling out of the two moving forward as well. But if you watch Leonardo in Invicta, she has a lot of those kind of just tricky veteran moves that a lot of people won't see. She has the wrestling. She is well-rounded. So very excited for this fight. And in a women's division where really three, four good wins can get you right up to the top. So entertaining fight.
Both of us going with Manon Fiorot to get the win. Overall, really looking forward to this card. We have Neil Magny taking on Michael Chiesa in the main event. 170-pound showcase. Really looking forward to it. So keep locked in with Fight Night Picks, Matt, as we always say. Let's get into it.